When building or upgrading a high-performance PC, choosing the right CPU cooling solution is crucial. Proper cooling keeps your processor operating at peak efficiency and prevents thermal throttling or damage under heavy workloads. Two of the most popular options for CPU cooling are air coolers and liquid coolers. In this video, we'll examine the differences between these two solutions to help you decide which is best for your needs. So, let's get started. First up, we've got traditional air coolers that are the traditional and budget-friendly choice for CPU cooling. At its core, it consists of a metal heatsink that absorbs and dissipates heat away from the CPU's integrated heat spreader. Aluminum fins connected to heat pipes provide increased surface area for heat dissipation. One or more fans mounted atop the heatsink draw cool air across the fins, accelerating heat transfer. Air coolers are self-contained units that mount directly onto the CPU socket. High-quality thermal paste improves heat conduction from the processor to the cooler's base plate. Installation is straightforward, only requiring you to attach mounting brackets, apply paste, and secure the cooler to the motherboard. Air coolers are an affordable and reliable cooling option, well-suited for stock-clocked CPUs.
Did you know that 72% of visitors are more likely to make their purchases soon after watching a product video? This makes it necessary to have a product demonstration or promo video for showcasing your product's potential values and benefits. At Product Video Studio, we are equipped with camera gear, tools, and most importantly, expertise to make your video captivating and engaging. Just send your products and we'll handle the rest. Contact us today to create something amazing together.
Now we come to liquid coolers, also called all-in-one or AIO coolers, which use liquid to absorb and transfer heat away from the CPU. A pump circulates coolant through a sealed loop, consisting of water blocks, tubing, and a radiator. The water block mounts to the CPU, allowing liquid to directly absorb heat. Tubing routes the heated liquid to a radiator, which has fans that dissipate the thermal energy. Cooled liquid then flows back to the water block, and the cycle repeats. Compared to bulky air coolers, AIO liquid coolers have a compact footprint, consisting of just the water block and tubing entering and exiting the case to connect to the external radiator. Many liquid coolers feature aesthetically pleasing designs with pump heads and tubing sleeves available in various colors. RGB lighting adds visual customization. Radiators come in a range of sizes to suit different cases, from slim profiles to robust dual fan models. Custom water cooling loops offer the ultimate in expandability and performance. Air CPU coolers provide excellent value, with budget options starting under $30 and high performance models around $80. Their simple construction keeps costs down. Liquid coolers carry a premium price, starting around $80 for a basic 120mm AIO and exceeding $150 for larger 360mm models with premium features. Custom liquid cooling loops require an even greater upfront investment in components like pumps, tubing, radiators, and custom water blocks. However, liquid cooling capabilities also scale with increased spending on higher performance hardware. Installing most air coolers is straightforward, with mounting hardware that is compatible with modern Intel and AMD CPU sockets. AIO liquid coolers require additional steps to mount the pump, connect tubing to the radiator, and install the radiator itself, often into case fan mounts. Leak testing is recommended after installing liquid coolers. Maintenance is also simpler for air coolers. Dusting fins or replacing thermal paste is all that's required. Liquid coolers may need occasional topping off of evaporated coolant and cleaning of water blocks. Custom loops require the most diligent maintenance to monitor fluid levels and component wear. high-performance air coolers can dissipate well over 200 watts of heat and cope with moderate CPU overclocking. Their limits depend on factors like heat sink size, fin surface area, and fan CFM ratings. But for extreme overclocking and heat loads exceeding 250 watts, liquid cooling excels. Liquid's higher specific heat capacity compared to air means AIO coolers can absorb spikes in thermal output, preventing temperature spikes, and radiators can expel more heat than heat sinks due to greater surface area. Custom loops offer the pinnacle of cooling capacity. Many high-quality air coolers use large, slow-spinning fans that generate minimal noise even at full speed. Smaller fans must spin faster, producing more noise. Liquid cooler fans usually operate at lower RPMs since cooling loads are distributed across the radiator. Pump noise is also minimal with quality AIOs. Overall, both types of coolers are much quieter than in the past, due to advances like hydrodynamic fan bearings. As always, check reviews to compare noise output between specific models. Air coolers come with limited aesthetic options beyond colored fans or shrouds. Liquid coolers often feature stylish pump heads and allow custom tubing sleeves. Built-in RGB lighting offers dynamic visuals. Radiators can even be mounted externally to showcase the liquid loop. And custom cooling opens up endless possibilities for advanced case mods and custom water blocks. For those seeking unique, eye-catching CPU cooling, Liquid is the way to go. Air and liquid cooling each excel in different scenarios. Air coolers like the Noctua NHD15 and Be Quiet. DarkRock Pro 4 provides affordable, quiet cooling for stock-clocked gaming PCs. For extreme overclocking and customizable aesthetics, liquid coolers like the NZXT Kraken Z73 and Corsair H150i Elite are better options, despite their higher initial cost. Evaluate your budget, CPU performance needs, noise limits, and customization preferences. Choosing the right cooler for your build will ensure optimal efficiency, thermal performance, and activity. Let us know which CPU cooling solution you picked and why in the comments.